Should we hear some?
Yeah, let's go for it.
What would you like to start with, Sean?
Would we start with the Deluxe?
Deluxe, should we hear the real thing and then hear the Helix, or would you like to hear the Helix and then the real thing?
Let's start with the real thing.
Real thing? We'll
try a couple of pedals on and off, we'll mess around and then
Okay. We'll
see where we're at.
Just so everybody knows, so the reverb that you're going to hear is coming from the Deluxe reverb, because why wouldn't you? And periodically, I might switch the chorus, the Boss CE2 chorus pedal on.
Sweet.
All make sense?
Sounds good.
I'll let you select.
Yeah.
Analog, so, we're on the thing. Superb.
Yeah, all good. Cool. So here's just here's a clean tone. All the pedals are off, just going straight in.
Mega. Right, so
sweet.
Let's maybe shift to the Helix
and
compare. And obviously, as we do this, I don't know why I'm looking at you, Vinny, because the camera's over here. As we do this, if you've got any comments, anything that you've got questions you want to ask, just blast them in the comments. Is that what you do with Facebook? Do you use the comments?
Yeah, comment.
Right, cool. Yeah, use the comments, and then we'll just have a bit of a two-way thing.
Sweet. Sounds good. So, yeah, on the Helix, I've got the same amp model dialed up, same cab, same mic, as I was saying. Here it is, just the clean tone. There's actually no reverb on this currently, but I'll switch some stuff in. So straight away I can hear, I probably have it dialed in to be a little bit more driven than the real
amp. It sounds really good though.
It sounds
this is out of my, this is all my, I know this, easy. I don't know this very well. That, sounds really...
It's really good, yeah.
I mean, it does sound like you plugged into an amp that's mic'd up and we're listening to the mic'd up signal. Which is kind of what you want. There's a bit of in-room stuff, but I don't know how it sounds on the Vinny, how would you describe it in 9 words?
9 words?
Yes.
Well, I've just used two. I think I've used all my 9 words now. Sorry. It sounds really great in the headphones. Hopefully it's coming through to people watching at home, even if they're watching on like a phone or something like that, which is how most people do listen to their to their stuff nowadays. It sounds really great. You can really hear a lot of sort of range in the frequencies, and it's nice and deep, but it's got all of the nice clarity. And
it sounds awesome in the room. And we're going through, just for monitoring, I think, the Line 6 power cab. And
sounds great.
Yeah.
What I'll do is...
Can you put chorus on that?
I can, yeah. So this is the 70s chorus model from the Helix.
Okay.
So straight away.
I miles away, is it?
It's pretty close,
They both sound like you plugged into Fender valve combos with some chorus. I mean, that sounds like at a gig, you'd be absolutely over the moon if that was your sound.
You'd be pretty happy with it.
Yeah.
I think to my ears, I can hear, this is what's great about the Helix's effects as well. I can show this on screen. The models on the Helix kind of take what real pedals can do a little further. So what I'm hearing is the depth is probably a little bit deeper on the Helix than the pedal is.
Yeah.
But I can back the mix down on the pedal.
Okay.
Which might make it a little bit closer. So if I bring this down to maybe 40-ish percent, and go back to the Helix. A little bit more subtle now. Which is kind of bridging the gap a bit,
yeah,
more there, which is nice.
Yeah. And I think when you've got those kind of, that ability to edit, mm-hmm, sort of to quite a fine detail, when you're sort of really honing in on a sound, like, I think that's where you get kind of inspired by stuff like that, that you then go, yeah, you know, if you sat at home and you've got a Helix and you're really kind of fine tuning until you get like, oh, that's the sound. It's, yeah, that makes you then, those moments we've all had where you go, oh my God, I've just been playing guitar for 3 hours.
Yeah, yeah.
And really I should be at work, or, you know, yeah, yeah. So, I mean, usually we're at work, so we're okay. But, you know, for people who don't work with guitars, that's a problem.
For sure.
I'm just going to interrupt you guys for 2 seconds because we've got, yeah, people, loads and loads of people want to see the pedals on the floor. Annoyingly, we've only got the 2 cameras. So I'm going to pick one up. I'm just going to quickly show people the pedals on the floor.
Yeah, of course.
Please do.
Cool.
Shall we fill while you do that?
Yeah, we'll just, you can talk.
Yeah, we'll just fill. No worry about it.
Yeah,
I, like I say, this is really interesting for me because, I mean, Vinny will tell you that I myself and kind of modern technology, except the man who's got his old valve amp with 6 knobs at home,
yeah, yeah,
you know. It's completely, like I say, this is out of my wheelhouse, so mm-hmm, it's actually really nice to kind of have a bit of a deeper dive,
yeah,
with this stuff, which is something we don't always get to do in,
yeah,
the store because,
yeah,
you know, we're busy actually doing our jobs. We,
yeah,
don't,
yeah,
actually play guitar that often at all. So this is going to be great. I'm really looking forward to this.
Yeah, it's cool. What I've done on that point as well, of like, you know, using the analog setups and, you know, what you see on the floor is what you get. I've basically done that on the Helix as well. So
it's a similar signal chain.
Exactly, yeah, because the Helix can do amazing complicated routings and all these things that are really fun if you want to deep dive into it. But what I've done is just set it up as simple as that setup is as well.
Cool.
Obviously, ABY switcher or ABC switcher aside,
yes,
with the complicated 3 amps and stuff aside, but
yeah, just set it up with 3 amps and some of this, and yeah.
So our first request that we've had is quite a few people asking to hear a bit of distortion, maybe through, yeah, through the amp. So
through the Fender.
Yeah, have we got a setup on the patch on the Helix to be able to put a bit of overdrive?
For sure, yeah.
Through there, and we can hear that.
Yeah. All right. To start off, so again, here's just the clean tone on its own. It's on the edge of breakup,
yeah,
which is nice because when we start adding overdrive pedals to this, let's kind of glue it together a little bit. So, yeah, the first one I've got here is the Scream 808, and I have it set up like a clean boost.
Yeah.
So a little bit of overdrive, but not too much. And this will just push it a little bit. Gonna add a little bit of delay. There we go. Just to cover up some of my mistakes. But here's the 808 again. So that's a very, very subtle overdrive, but it's just adding that mid-range push,
yeah,
into the amp that's already on the edge of breakup.
So I think, well, the interesting thing there is, that's some lovely playing, by the way.
Cheers,
as well.
Nice one.
That's some real, I've had a little moment there, I was just watching you. I'm like, that. Oh, I've got to do some talking. So we've got a tube screamer down here,
yeah.
TS9, 808, TS9. It's the same thing, it's the same pedal. So
you've just upset a lot of people.
It's the same pedal, innit? So we could do, let's do the deluxe reverb with maybe a bit of the, it's set much the same way as a clean bass.
Yeah, and
sort of hear how that, let me give you, there you are, bit of tube screamer.
Cool. So, here we go.
Push, you can hear what the tube screamer is doing, kind of.
For sure. The cool thing about using a pedal like the tube screamer as a boost into a clean on the edge of breakup amp is the pedal very much becomes a part of the amp sound.
Oh, definitely.
As opposed to just being like a pedal.
100%. And is that something that, so again, I think we always find ourselves that moment where you realize, a boosted amp actually sounds different than just an amp with the drive turned up.
For sure.
It's kind of got this different character. Like you say, this sort of, everything's, I don't know, maybe a bit more together and a bit more, it all sounds like a thicker, fuller sound for my money.
Absolutely, yeah.
Is that the same with Helix if you, because that's kind of what we were hearing there, that if you load up maybe a couple of boosts in front of an amp that's on edge or a driven amp, that it reacts in that same kind of way?
For sure, yeah. And that's kind of the way I've learned to use amplifiers with pedals.
Yeah.
Years ago, I had the mindset of like, I set my amp up clean, and then I've got like a distortion pedal.
Yeah.
I've got a light overdrive pedal, and I use my pedals as different stages of gain. But I've learned that having the amp cranked that little bit, that it's overdriving when you dig in.
Yeah.
And using really like transparent, well, the tube screamer isn't a transparent amp or overdrive, but
it adds something to it. Yeah.
Yeah. Using a pedal not just for its overdrive characteristics, but more for its color and its push into the amp.
Yeah.
Will give it a certain sound. And yeah, that's how I did it here with the Scream 808 as well. What I find is that when you're using a pedal in that way, the tone becomes such a really sculpting tool.
Yes.
The tone knob on the pedal. And you really start to hear the color of it depending on where you place it. A lot of people leave it just at, 12 o'clock.
But yeah.
You can really shape your tone by moving it left to right.
And do you tend to go like, do you like a slightly brighter kind of thing where you can hear more going on, or do you prefer something a bit smoother?
For me, I think I go for the smoother tones.
Okay.
Probably because it hides more mistakes.
But, I can't comment. I'm purposely not holding a guitar or have a guitar anywhere near me for that very reason.
all the pressure's on me.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I guess so. That's kind of Fender. That's the kind of Fender wheelhouse.
Yeah, yeah.